Welcome back. Welcome back. This is Peaceful Tranquility Realized, and I am Mike Wilson. Today, we're going to do a 50-minute yoga session. Enjoy. All right, starting on our backs. Lift your chest, drop your shoulders to your hips. Stretch your hands out towards your feet, chin towards your chest. And start to inhale, lifting the stomach. Exhale, pull it in. Feel free to use your hand or hands, stacking, not interlacing the hands. And letting the hand be guided by the abdomen. And try to empty the air on an exhale as we go into soft cleansing breaths. Slowly letting the air out. Emptying the lungs and filling them right back again. If you feel a feeling of like you're gonna run out of breath, exhaling long, as soon as you're done, slowly inhale, pulling all that energy back. And let's go for some hard cleansing breaths. Make sure you're opening the mouth wide. Don't be alarmed by any tingling you feel in your scalp. And moving on to lateral leg raises, pressing knees to the chest. Stretching out on the exhale, inhaling the knees into the chest. Bring the chin up a little bit. Tighten the abdomen. Keep the breath rhythmic. Go into some knee rotations, rotating to the right. Just a couple or three. Go into the other side and make sure the feet are coming close to the ground so the tailbone is being massaged. Going to grab the shins with the hands and continue rotating knees. Getting comfortable with it, bringing the knees really close to the chest, opening up the hips. Firing the muscle groups in a small, slow fashion. And let's go for a child's pose. Hands in the arches of the feet, pulling the knees towards the underarms and keeping the tailbone down close towards the ground. You can also hold on to your toes also. And I grab onto the heels to really allow myself to straighten the legs, bringing the toes down towards the ground, keeping the hips where they are. And always adjust to find a better area where I can relax and let gravity pull my legs straight. Trying to straighten the backs of the knees. And going for some supine twists, right leg on top of the left and leaning over to the left first. Relaxing that right hip, the left knee. And thigh are holding down that right leg. Very small move.
but it's also effective for countering this next one. We're just leaning over to the right, and that right leg is heavy on top of the left. And now we're stretching out the left quadricep from the hip down to the knee. Switching legs and over to the right, opening up the left hip, but remember the stretch is going to be in the right quadricep. As we move over to the left side and keep that breath going, exhaling every time you want to stretch out even more, go deeper into the stretch, you inhale and exhale. Allow the legs and knees to get to the ground. And the next here is seated pigeon. It's going to make our way up. So we're going to push yourself on up. Rock on up, hands out, and the fingers can be away or behind you towards the back of you. And you're going to put the right leg or right shin on the left thigh and dig deep, putting the hip to the ground or just hang, trying to keep the arms as straight as possible, dropping the shoulders, and just breathe into that stretch on the right hamstring, as you can see. And that left knee should be right over the ankle, allowing some support. If the knee is pushed past the left toe, just go on and adjust back. And I start pretty far and I work my way in. You can take this pose a little bit deeper by bringing the chest closer to the thighs. And just still breathe from the abdomen here. Sometimes we're tighter on the left side versus the right, or vice versa. And don't let that alarm you. We're gonna go for a bridge from here. Take care of the wrist. You can also stretch here and go into this. So we're gonna go for some bridge pulses, high bridge pulses. Exhale down. I'm turning the hands towards, which is a little bit more difficult on the wrists and the forearms. But make sure you're doing this with an inhale and an exhale, releasing. And we're going to go for a seated pigeon now. Right shin in front of the left thigh, grab it on inside the thigh, and we're going to do a full-on seated pigeon, which we're going to bring the chin to the chest, forehead to the shin there. Hold it as long as you can, just three breaths here. It's a very invigorating pose, opening up the spine, the hips, the neck, and try not to strain. Allow the breaths to come in, expanding the abdomen. Exhale, letting them go, and let go on the exhale. And I'm just stretching out my hamstrings here. It's also another supine twist. And switching to the next side, left shin on the right thigh. You can keep the leg up, that right leg can stay up, or you can bend it, but just relax the legs. Only thing that's really tight is the abdomen, keeping the chin towards the chest. And of course, I know some people would like to bring their knee or their forehead to the knee, but try not to strain. Side again, another twist. Right hand holding onto that left ankle and left hand holding onto the right ankle, and just bringing the legs close to the body. All right. There's a few back rocks here after the supine twist, really focusing on the spine. Those last poses were, so just a little stretch. You can also pull the feet back for plow. Here we are in cross leg position, and you can also go for half lotus, stacking the legs. Also, true half lotus is actually bringing one of the feet on top of the thigh, which you'll see me do in a moment. Take your time, especially if you're new. And once you get a good position, lift the chest, drop the shoulders, and bend the elbows. Keep the elbows bent. And shoulder blades slightly towards each other, lifting the neck and head, and dropping the chin slightly towards the chest, allowing the back of the neck to be flat for smooth inhales and exhales. And set an intention for your class, focusing in on the breath, the strength of the breath, maybe lack of strength. And deepen your inhales, exhale, pulling all the air out, tightening the abdomen, pulling it in towards the spine. And inhale nice and deep, pulling in all that good oxygen, getting ready to start. Dropping the hands out to the ground and inhale up, palms together, inhale, exhale, inhale, looking up, exhale, inhale, palms together, and turn the palms up, stretching up for exhale, and inhale, and exhale, slowly drop the hands, looking down, stretching the shoulders out, and flipping those hands over, inhale, hold the breath, and exhale, hands down, inhale, and stretching out, and exhale, coming down, and inhale, we're going to interlace those fingers, pointing the index fingers up, we're going to go for some breathing, using the mouth closed with the ah, and exhale. Doing 10 of these. Hold the breath at the top and exhale, stretching the hands down. We're gonna go for a spinal twist. You can keep the left hand back onto the ground, or you can go in and grab that right hip. And make sure when you're twisting that you're dropping the shoulders, lifting the head and neck. And slowly turn around, stretching the hands up, resetting the spine and arms. And do the same thing on the other side. That left hand, allow it to be soft. Try not to grip too hard. Try not to strain at any time. Start where you are and use the breath to go deeper. Inhale, stretching those hands up. Interlacing the hands behind our back, stretching the chest forward, looking up, dropping the head. And we're going to go for seated extended side angles. Dropping the hands to the chest and resetting. Inhale. Exhale. And inhale, pushing the hands up. And exhale, dropping the right hand to the side and reaching over with the left. Stretching over there. Make sure the right hand is spread wide. Looking up to the sky for extra stretch. And inhale, coming up, hands up. And exhale, drop that left
reaching over with the right, looking under that underarm, looking at the sky, bringing the chest towards the sky. And inhale the hands back up, and exhale hands to chest. And here we go, moving on, going for a cross-legged forward fold, inhaling the hands up, nice and deep inhale, and exhale, dropping the head back, and dropping the chest towards the thighs, palms down, stretching the hands out first, and then allowing a little bend in the elbows. Inhale, pushing the stomach against the thighs, and walking over, hand over hand to the right, framing the right knee, forehead or chest towards the thigh. If you can't rest your forehead on the thigh, it's okay. You can also stack the hands on the knee, relaxing the shoulders, keeping the breath going, expanding the abdomen against the thighs, and exhale, pulling it away from the thighs. And we're continuing with the yin side of this yoga practice today. We're gonna go on and bring the fingers inside the toes. And we're going to circle the ankle. Go slower than me, I'm going a little bit fast. But take your time. And then we're gonna take that left hand and grab the right leg with the right arm and lean back, opening the hips, and just swing nice and fluid. Make sure you inhale and exhale into these movements. And let's go for a half shoelace, placing that right shin on the left thigh. Avoid the knee at all costs. Relaxing the chest towards the thigh. And let's cross over again. Go for a supine twist. And putting that right hand behind us. And try to grab onto the left hip. Dropping the shoulders. Try not to strain. Allow the spine to release all the tension. And let's go for a full shoelace, dropping that knee towards the ground. My hips are tight, but take your time, allow gravity to hold that leg down. Always adjust if you need to get deeper. And moving on, going for the left leg. And going for the half shoelace. Taking your time, breathing. And inhaling up, we're gonna go for spinal twist here. And place the sole of the foot, left foot, over the right thigh for spinal twist. Lifting the head, dropping the shoulders, pushing the chest forward, dropping everything down to the hips. And turning around. And let's go for full shoelace. And let's start to move on here, coming on up and meeting me at tabletop. We're going to lean back onto our heels with the feet curled for scribe. The pose of the scribe. To get comfortable in this position, you can also uncurl the toes and sit on the tops of the feet. Don't be alarmed with any popping. If it gets too unbearable, you can use a block or two. And once you get comfortable in that spot, allow the hips to fall down towards the heels. And use also this position to open up the toes. And spread the knees nice and wide here, curling the toes, bringing the heels together. And use a block to get comfortable in this position, which is not that comfortable. If you have tight toes, tight knees, very beneficial to take time to relax the shoulders. And come out of that position nice and slow. And to kind of recover, go on and tap the tops of the toes onto the ground and in tabletop. Let's go for child's pose here, just for a moment. Relaxing here and inhale, pulling yourself back. Put the hands behind you for a half bridge, lifting the chest and hips, dropping the head back. And pulse here, kind of open up the hips. And I'll show you behind, knees wide. You can also put one foot on top of the other, stretching out the hamstring. I'm stretching out the ankles some more. Stretching out the feet, especially if you wear heels or dress shoes or tight gym shoes. It's a good way to get some release out of tight feet. Let's go for a bird dog here. Stretching that right leg out, pulsing to the chest. Just opening up the legs and the feet from everything we did, bringing that knee in for a fire hydrant. You can also pause there as well at the fire hydrant. Go to the left side, stretching that left leg out there and press to the chest, back and forth. Swinging the knees in a circle, taking your time. Let's go for this sequence here from child's pose to upward facing. And when you're ready, inhale, coming up, and exhale, bringing the hips towards the ground, legs straight, arms straight. Inhaling and exhaling, looking up, dropping the hips. And knees wide, and take the hips into a circle. Still accentuating the hips towards the ground as we come forward. And do this as many times as you want. Each time you can feel the power in the arms. And we're just going to bring the chin and chest to the ground, stretching the hands out, keeping the hips up, hips over the ground and the knees behind. Good for the lower back. and getting ready to take it up a notch as we come standing, bringing the hands to the chest and keeping the knees down, pushing back. Here we go, stretching out for a plank. And pushing back to downward dog. Walking the legs, bending one, stretching the other, connecting the hip with the heel, pushing down to the ground. Let's go for a dolphin, coming down on the elbows and forearms, trying to straighten those legs, pushing the hips down and the heels to the ground. And we're going to come out of this dolphin back into downward dog. Take your time. Go slow. Drop the head. And walk the feet up to meet the hands. Like a forward fold here, bringing the forehead towards the knees. Maybe grab the backs of the thighs, the legs, bringing the forehead even closer. Bending the elbows. And bend the knees, inhaling, coming up. And exhale, leaning back for a back bend, opening the arms. And exhale, hands to chest. Let's go for a journey of Ra. Inhaling the hands up. And exhale, swan dive. Dropping the head and pushing the left leg back for lunge. Make sure the knee is right over the ankle and that left leg is straight, curling the toe as we come up for high lunge. And allow your hips to fall towards the ground. And we're gonna go for extended side angle. Take your time. Exhale, bring the hand down and push that right foot back. Stretching it out, and we're gonna go for an upward facing. Chest to the ground and lift up, keeping the hips close to the ground. Looking up, trying to stretch those arms straight and pushing back to downward dog. Allowing the shoulder blades to come close together, looking at the belly button here. And walk the feet up to meet the hands. Keep the head low. And when you're ready, bend the knees and inhale coming up. And let's go for a back bend. And exhale, hands to chest. And let's move on. Mountain pose into exalted, stretching the arms out. And right leg goes back. And make sure the knee is over the ankle, stretching the right leg straight. And here we go, high lunge on the right. Take a deep inhale and exhale, coming down for extended, dropping that right hand down, left hand goes up, stretching out, and try to connect the tailbone to the base of the skull. Dropping that left hand, and we're gonna push the left leg back again. And leaning forward into low plank. This is also a variation. I'm using the knees to go to upper facing. Slowly bending the elbows and pushing back up to plank. Pushing down to downward dog. Adjust the hands. Make sure the fingers are wide. And you're pushing directly into the palms. Wide legs to get a deeper stretch. And when you're ready, take a deep inhale and exhale, walking the feet to meet the hands. And keep the head down. And exhale, bringing the chest close to the thighs, keeping the forehead close to the knees. Maybe bending the elbows as you hold on, and reverse swan dive. And dropping the palms to the chest. And let's do a standing spinal twist. Bending the elbows. Elbows in line with the shoulders, feet together. And just turning to the side and holding it there. Trying to keep the hips towards the front. Stretching the rib cage and the abdomen area. Let's go for another side stretch, grabbing the right wrist with the left hand, leaning over, keeping the chest going towards the sky, and opposite side. And let's go for a lizard pose. So we're going to inhale, coming down, and we're going to drop that left leg back, leaning forward, and then bend the knee. And we're going to go inside of the right foot, both hands. And we're going to drop down to the elbows. Allow yourself to drop down to the ground through the hips. Drop the head and maybe bring the forearms to the ground. You can also use a block here also. Remember to keep your breath rhythmic and calm. But still intense. And I'm gonna push up that right foot for a half split, dropping the forehead to the knees, chest to the thigh, stretching those hands out, framing the left foot there. And stretching that right arm up for a twist. And go for the left hand into the sky. Doing both sides. Let's go on and bring that right and left hand over the right leg. Looking to the right, feeling that stretch alongside your left rib cage. And we're gonna go on and push back for a three-legged downward facing. Lifting that right leg up. Stretching it all the way out. Feeling the strength from the foot to the hand. And go for a scorpion. Dropping that leg back there, opening up the hips. Looking under the underarm, stretch the leg back. It's going to bring the knee to the chest. Scooping up for up dog. And pushing back to downward facing. And going to lengthen that right leg up again. And we're going to bring the right foot all the way to the front. Take your time. Plant and up for a high lunge. And going to push forward with your own might. Stretch those hands up. Let's go for a back bend. And let's go on and push the hips back. Bend the knees for chair. Inhaling the hands up. and leaning down, pushing the hips back, bend the knees. And you can just bring the hands up, palms facing, or you can interlace the fingers, pointing the index fingers up. Breathe as you lean into the heels, leaning back into the hips. Slight back bend here. Go for this lunge, low lunge. And we're gonna go for the lizard. I'm gonna bring both hands inside the left leg. And you can use that block. I'll use the block this time. And bring the forearms to the ground or the yoga block. Drop the head and neck, relax the shoulders. Yeah, moving into half split, we're gonna pop that left foot up, toes into the air, stretching that left leg straight. Right hip right over the knee and lean forward, dropping the forehead to the knee and chest towards the thigh. Framing that left foot with both hands. And going for a twist here. Make sure that right hand is firm and in line with the left, same on the side, left hand down firm, spreading the fingers and right hand stretched up there, chest towards the sky. Dropping the hand, and yes, keep the breath going. Both hands over the left leg, turning towards the left, looking towards the left. For a full stretch on the right side, hip to shoulder. Now let's go on and come out of here as we bend the left knee and stretch that right leg straight and kick that left foot back there. And inhale as we push the left leg up. Going for a scorpion, dropping the left leg behind our back, bending the knee, and look under the armpit of the left arm. Stretch that leg straight behind us and slowly bring that knee in, connecting the foot to the ground. And we're gonna come all the way up, leaning forward and backwards, bringing both feet together, getting ready for the warrior sequence, dropping back for back bend, and dropping the hands down to the side. And inhale the hands back up, palms together, and exhale, diving all the way down. Drop the left foot back and bend that knee, hands up, heel, left heel to the ground for warrior one. Let's go for that reverse warrior. Arching the back, lifting the chest, stretching that right hand out there, reaching. You can go for a bind there, left hand to the right thigh. And warrior two, keeping that knee bent, turning to the front, curling the left toe. And we're going to slowly come back to warrior two and go back to reverse warrior. Take a deep inhale and exhale. And inhale, just drop that right hand down, either bringing the forearm to the thigh or the hand right next to the right. Left hand up, stretching out there. Yes, also use a block if necessary. If you feel too stretched out when you bring the hand next to the right leg. And stretch the left arm over the ear, over the left ear, And let's straighten the right leg, bringing the left hand in line with the right arm. And let's go ahead and frame that right foot, right leg straight. And here we go, reverse triangle. And inhale back to warrior two, bending that knee. Turn the chest towards the front on that left toe and bring both feet together and go for a back bend. Dropping the hands next to us. And inhale. Exhale and inhale again. Swan dive. Stepping that right foot back. And we're going to lift up, drop that right heel to the ground. Bending the knee, warrior one into warrior two. And let's go for reverse warrior. Dropping that right hand to the thigh. Or bring the right hand behind the back, grabbing onto that left hip. Back to warrior two. And go for another reverse warrior. Extended side angle here. Keep the breath going, especially if this is a tight position for you. Keeping the right arm straight over the right ear. And straighten the left leg. Frame the left leg here. And inhale, stretching up. Exhale, reverse triangle. And when you're ready, take a deep inhale and bend that left knee right over the left foot. Turn the chest towards the front, curl the right toe. And when you're ready, lift all the way up, stretching the hands into the air and go for a back bend. And let's find our seated position in chair. Leaning into the heels, leaning into the hips. Exhale, bringing the hands down. And getting ready for warrior sequence, bringing the hands to the chest. And leaning over for a forward fold. And step the left foot back for lunge, low lunge. And from here, we're gonna move into warrior three. Stretching that left leg up behind. You can also use a block. And going and connect the base of the skull to the tailbone, straight back, straight legs. You can always bend that knee that's on the ground for stability. And we're swinging the leg, left leg onto the right thigh for figure four. I'll show you here in the front. Slowly coming up, taking your time, breathing from the abdomen to keep you balanced. Making short, small moves. Always keeping the shoulders towards the hips, chest out. Inhale, hands up and exhale, hands down. And let's go for the other side. Making your way back to the front of the mat. Inhaling the hands up. And exhale, swan dive, forward fold, kicking that right foot back. Getting into a nice lunge, but then going into the warrior three, pushing that right foot. And here we go. Finding the balance. Flex the right toe here. And bending both knees and smoothly bringing yourself to figure four here. Hands to the chest. And just relax. At any time, if I do a pose, if it's too fast, you can always pause and work on it as long as you need to. Let's take a deep inhale, bringing the hands up, coming out for back bend, and for fold. Take a deep inhale, and exhale, bend the knees. And we're going to bring ourselves to the mat for seated bridge pose. Bringing the knees to the chest and going to bring those heels close to the hips and lift the hips up into the air, chin close to the chest. And if you want, you can interlace the hands behind you, under you, and hold it here, breathing. Make sure you're breathing from the abdomen here, and that you're actively pushing your hip bones to the sky. Try not to strain, but give your best effort. As we're on our back here, getting ready to close out, we're gonna do some supine twists. Starting with that left leg stretching out in the front, and we're gonna bring the right leg over to the left, airplaning the arms, and look to your left. Then look to your right, and sustain your gaze to your right. Make sure that the left leg that is straight, the toe is flexed, but still relaxing. Finding that belly breath here, making sure the inhales are preparing you to maybe even take your stretch even further. Trying to bring that right knee to the ground. And let's reset, bringing the knees to the chest, bringing the forehead to the knees, relaxing, bringing the shoulder blades up. And let's go in and drop the right leg, stretch it out nice and far. And with the exhale, pulling that left knee to the right of you. And yes, if the knee doesn't go down, don't force it. Just add the hand and maybe push the buttocks back. Trying to get the knee down, but take your time. And here we are, the last pose, mummy pose. Throughout the sequences shown today, remember, mummy pose is always a way to reset the nervous system, to revisit the circulatory system, how the blood flows through your body. Your body is flat. I want you to take deep inhales and deep exhales. And try to always find the rhythm between the inhale and the exhale. Inhales, obviously bringing in oxygen for you to breathe, for you to be animated in your vessel. So always focus in on good inhales and expelling all that is not needed for exhale. Listen to the feeling that you are emitting through your skin, through your mind. Are you at balance? Are you still shaky? Are you still thinking about the outside world? Deepen your breath more. You can use a yoga block to keep a tab on how you're breathing. When you're ready, remove the block if you've added a block, and take a deep inhale.
And exhale, bringing the hands to the sides of your feet together and lifting up, looking at your toes. Just hold it there for a moment and stretch the hands up and lean over for forward fold. Opening up the back, bend the elbows, drop the forehead and neck towards the knee. Just breathe, pushing the abdomen against the thighs. And when you're ready, inhale, slowly come up. And meet me at cross leg position to close out. Take this time to meditate in cross leg position. Filling the belly with inhales. And exhaling, contracting the belly. Lifting the chest, dropping the shoulders, tilting the chin towards the chest, and take time to observe how you feel now versus when you first started on your mat, and review over those places that feel a little tight still. No worries, deep inhales and exhale. Allow your posture to adjust so you can relax those spaces, knees, ankles, hips, back, shoulders, neck. And let's close it out, inhaling the hands up, circling the aura, palms to the forehead, bringing all that energy into good thinking and good heart. Thank you. Thanks for watching again. Please like, subscribe, and share. Thank you.